who's fearless. She has remarkable perspective. She enables dialogue in any situation she is into.
Sue is such a trailblazer, somebody that breaks through barriers that haven't been broken through before.
I'm a girl from Canal Flats in the East Kootenays, where my dad was the principal and my mom was the teacher. When I was a teenager, I was guiding pack trains of horses and guests from all around the world to experience the wilderness and the wildlife. Those kinds of experiences have made me in many ways who I am. I was very, very fortunate as a young lawyer to start my career with a really well-respected firm in Vancouver called Russell & Dumoulin. I developed, along with Trish Jansen, a practice in human rights, really exploring in the early 80s the whole concept of discrimination in the workplace. I was the first female managing partner in Russell & Dumoulin, one of the very first female managing partners in Canada. I had the great honor and obligation to make that successful.
Sue's real talent is getting people to the same place, mediation, building teams. And I think that's why, after she'd been the first woman managing director of Russell & Dumoulin, she had done it all there, and so she wanted to go out and test herself.
Being the CEO of PharmaSave allowed me to move into the business community and really see the operations of a major national organization from the inside out. And I loved it every moment from the first day I was there. The organization was really blossoming and new technologies were being brought in, and I could feel myself getting ready for a new opportunity to take an organization that was a really well-respected testing facility and grow it into what I think now is one of the most respected healthcare and technology companies in the country. What I see in Life Labs is, in our relationship with BCIT, is a strong, long-standing relationship where BCIT has educated and trained technologists for the lab floor for decades. I know in Life Labs, BCIT grads have the opportunity to work pretty much across the country. I've been very, very fortunate throughout my life to be mentored by men and women across all parts of the community and all parts of the country. And I can say to this day, some of the most meaningful lessons that I've had on leadership, on community engagement, and on caring came from being at the shoulder of Don Ricks through the BCIT Foundation in the early 1980s. And I think as parents and as community leaders, that's our obligation.
I think why Sue is such a strong role model for female leaders is that combination, that ability to be that visionary, to trailblaze ahead, not to let anything get in the way.
She will advocate for women within her organization and within the community to ensure that their success is assured. For her, their success is her success.
The kind of leadership we're going to need in the Canadian healthcare system are leaders that have strong technical skills, but also leaders who can see the future, who can help define the future, and who know how to drive through complex situations, navigate ambiguity, and make decisions. And those are exactly the kind of people that are graduated out of BCIT. BCIT is going to play a huge part in the future success of the Canadian healthcare system and the life sciences sector.